بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، اللهم صل على محمد. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. All praise you to Allah alone, we praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness, we repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead, and whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. Every time you try to speak about the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, about our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I see that there is an ocean before me, an ocean without an end. No matter how I try to find the other end, I will never be able to find the other end. I will never be able to reach the other end. No matter how good of a swimmer I could be, I will never be able to reach to the other end. Why? Because there is no other end. Every great person in the history of mankind was great because he acquired one or two or few good qualities. But when it comes to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he reached the peak of excellence of all good qualities that a man can attain. Subhanallah. So I acknowledge my weakness and that I'm not able to give justice to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam when I speak about his life. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam reached the peak of excellence in every good quality attainable by human being. Subhanallah. And if you want to know the qualities of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, just read the Quran. Look at the Quran. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Indeed, O Muhammad, you are upon great manners. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assembled all the great qualities, the excellence of manners, the best of virtues, and the great character in the person of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you look at his humbleness, you will find him that has reached the peak of excellence. If you look at his mercy, you will find him that has reached as well the peak of excellence. If you look at his subhanAllah ta'ala wisdom, you will find him that he reached the peak of excellence in that matter, on that field. If you look at his piety, worship, devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find him that he has reached as well the peak of excellence of that. If you look at his forgiveness, gentleness, you will find him that he has reached the peak of excellence of that quality, subhanAllah. Allahu Akbar. And that's why Allah ta'ala in the Quran said to us, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Indeed, you have in the person and the character of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam a great example for you. Allahu Akbar. And that's why we see the Quran is addressing the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam in a different style. Allah Ta'ala will not address the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the Quran by his name. Allah will only address him by his title. But look at the other prophets. Allah Ta'ala will call them by their names. Ya Musa, aqbil wa la takhaf. O Musa, come forward and don't be scared. Ya Ibrahim, a'rid an hadha. O Ibrahim, forsake this matter. يا آدم ادخل أنت وزوجك الجنة. O Adam, enter you and your wife to Jannah. سبحان الله. يا عيسى بن مريم. O عيسى, the son of Mary. أأنت قلت للناس اتخذوني وأمي إلهين من دون الله. Did you tell people to worship you and your mother and put you as gods before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So Allah ta'ala is addressing all the prophets by their names. But when it comes to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah ta'ala will only address him by his title. Look at the Quran. يا أيها النبي لا يا أيها النبي لم تحرم ما أحل الله لك. Oh, the Prophet, why you made something forbidden while it's Allah Ta'ala made it lawful to you? يا أيها النبي حسبك الله. Oh, the Prophet, Allah is sufficient for you. حسبك الله ومن اتبعك من المؤمنين. Allah is sufficient for you and for all the followers who follow your religion, subhanAllah. يا أيها الرسول لا يحزنك الذين يسارعون في الكفر. Oh, the messenger, don't be grieved with those who are hasting each other, those who are vying each other in disbelief. Subhanallah. Allah will only address him by his title, the title of prophethood, the title of messengerhood. The Prophet, the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just to see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, that will give you the status of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. Indeed, we raised high for you your repute. We raised high for you your name. And until today, subhanAllah ta'ala, almost over 1400 years from the prophethood and sending Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to people, to mankind, until now, people are remembering the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sending prayers upon him, and even the adhan is called. And we remember his name, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, Allahu Akbar. This great Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this great messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was a great example for all of us. If you look at his biography, if you look in the way how he used to treat people around him, his enemies, his companions, the women in his society, the children in his society, subhanAllah ta'ala, he was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam indeed a mercy to all of humanity. And that's why Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Indeed, we have not sent you, O Muhammad, except as a mercy to all of humanity. لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Allahu Akbar. And that's why the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the people of Mecca were fighting him at the Battle of Uhud, and they injured his face, and the blood was dropping from his face. And the companions said to him, oh, Rasulullah, make dua against the disbelievers. Pray against them. And the Nabi ﷺ raised his hand and said, oh Allah, forgive my nation. Oh Allah, forgive my people, because they don't know. اللهم اهدي قومي فإنهم لا يعلمون. والله guide them as they don't know. الله أكبر. And likewise, when the people of Quraysh, when Allah Ta'ala enabled him, Allah Ta'ala enabled him to conquer Mecca, when he retired Mecca, the people of Mecca who forced him out of Mecca, and the people of Mecca who killed his followers and his companions, people of Mecca who tortured him and tortured his companions and his tribe, people of Mecca who waged wars against him for 5 years. And at the 21st year of his Prophet ﷺ, he returned back to Mecca, and he was, Allah Ta'ala enabled him to conquer Mecca without any bloodshed. Subhanallah. And he entered Mecca. People of Mecca said to him, when they gathered all of them together, waiting for his decision upon them, he told them, how do you expect me to treat you? مَا تَظَنُّونَ أَنِّي فَاعِلٌ بِكُمْ. They all said, collectively, أَخٌ كَرِيمٌ إِبْنُ أَخٍ كَرِيمٌ. You are a noble man, a son of a noble man. And his Asallam said, اِذْهَبُوا فَأَنْتُمُ الطُّلَقَى. Go, you are free. You are free. لَا تَثْرِيبَ عَلَيْكُمْ. There is no reproach upon you today. There is no blame, even the blame. There is no blame upon you today. يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. May Allah forgive you. And He is the most merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the answer. Look at the way and the example that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given to us in treating his enemies. Allahu Akbar. Women at the time of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to be disregarded. They used to be belittled. But the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the Muslims, that the best amongst you are those who are the best to their wives. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, استوصوا بالنساء خيرا. Umar radiallahu anhu said that we used to regard women less than men that time, subhanAllah. We used to belittle them. But Islam came and gave them dignity. Allahu Akbar. And then Salam said, at the last time or last moments of his life, استوصوا بالنساء خيرا. Treat women well. Children. He used to sallam, lead the believers, the companions. And then when he used to hear the cry of the child, he used to pray fast. Why? Because he doesn't want his mother to be annoyed. He says, I used to stand for prayer and I want to prolong the prayer and I hear the child crying and I shortcut. Why? Because I don't want to cause anxiety in the heart of his mother. Subhanallah. Great example for all of us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This great man, this great prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, took an oath from every single prophet. If I send at your time Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will believe in him and you will support him and you will follow him. And every single prophet said, oh Allah, I acknowledge this. Oh Allah, I will deliver this. Oh Allah, I will follow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ. And when Allah Ta'ala took the covenant from all the prophets when they were at the back or in the back of Adam, when they were in the back of Adam alayhi salam before they were born in the unseen world, subhanallah, Allah Ta'ala took of them an oath. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ ميثاق النبيين لما آتيتكم من كتاب وحكمة. The ulama said, Allah Ta'ala took an oath from them when they were in the unseen world. And some said, before they were sent, Allah Ta'ala will take from an oath from every one of them, every single one of them. Subhanallah. By the wisdom that I have given you, and by the knowledge and the scripture that I have given you, ثم جاءكم رسول مصدق لما معكم. Then a messenger came to you confirming what you have with you. لا تؤمنن به ولا تنصرنه. You shall believe in him and you shall support him and you shall follow him. And every one of them said, oh Allah, I acknowledge this. قال أقررتم وأخذتم على ذلكم إصري. Allah Ta'ala said, are you willing to take my covenant? Will you take up my covenant? All of them said, oh Allah. قالوا أقررنا. Oh Allah, we acknowledge. Oh Allah, we will follow him. Musa said, oh Allah, if Muhammad was sent at my time, I shall support him, I shall follow him. Isa likewise said, oh Allah, if Muhammad was sent at my time, I shall support him and follow him. Ibrahim said the same. And every single prophet said the same. If Muhammad was sent at our time, we shall believe in him and we shall support him. This is the status of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قَالُوا أَقْرَرُنَا. قال فاشهدوا وأنا معكم من الشاهدين. Allah Ta'ala said, bear witness. And I am among the witnesses. I'm with you among the witnesses. Allahu Akbar, subhanallah ta'ala. This is the status of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The mercy to mankind. The great example sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The one whom by his guidance and his direction and his teachings that the Muslims are trying to reflect the best of men, subhanallah ta'ala. If you want to know him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, read through his biography. Read his statements, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Read his ahadith, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are full of wisdom. They are full of guidance. They are full of direction. Allahu Akbar. This great Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to love you. And he used to think about you. He, in one occasion, left his house. It was the last month of his life. Left his house and went to the graveyard. And he found, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the companions coming after him. He entered the graveyard and said, "Assalamu alaykum dara qawmi mu'mineen wa inna insha'allahu bikum lahiqun." Peace be upon you, a dwelling of believing men and women, and we shall soon come with you here. We shall soon follow you. Subhanallah. And then he said, and the companions were around him. He said, "Wadidtu anni law ra'aytu ikhwani. I wish that I can see my brothers." Subhanallah. The companions said, "Messenger of Allah, aren't you brothers?" He said, "No, you are my companions. But my brothers are those who will come after you, who have not come into the world yet. Those who will come after you and believe in me without seeing me. They are my brothers. And I wish I can see them." Subhanallah. The companions said, "Messenger of Allah, will you be able to recognize them and know them on the Day of Judgment?" He said, "Yes, indeed, certainly, I will." Imagine if you have, he said, if you have, لو أن لأحدكم خيلا غرا محجلا, if one of you had white-footed horses and with white foreheads amongst pure black horses, will he be able to recognize and distinguish his own horses? The companion said, "Messenger of Allah, yes, certainly, he'll be able to know his forces." He said, "Likewise, my followers, they will come on the Day of Judgment, and their limbs will be bright. Their limbs and their faces will be bright, will be white, will beam in brightness out of the trace of wudu." Subhanallah. Allahu Akbar. The true followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are those who adhere to the prayers. They offer the prayers. They pray and they do wudu, Allahu Akbar. And that's why, and this is a sign through which the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will know you. So dear brothers and sisters, if you are in short of offering the prayers, make sure that you rectify this matter. Because this is the sign through which the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will know you on the Day of Judgment. Allahu Akbar. And then he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "وَأَنَا فَرَطُهُمْ عَلَى الْحُوَضِ," and I will be ahead of them on the hawd. And that hawd, if you drink from it, you will never feel thirsty after that at all. Allahu Akbar. مَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهُ لَمْ يَرْمَ أَبَدًا. Subhanallah. If you just want as well to know the mercy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa, the love that he had for you, for us, for his nation, for human being in general, subhanAllah ta'ala, read this story. In one occasion, the Nabi sallam recited the verse in which Ibrahim alayhi salam said, "Rabbi innahunna adlalna kathiran minan nas." O Allah, those idols have led many people astray. "فَمَنْ تَبِعَنِي فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي فَمَنْ تَبِعَنِي فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ." This is Ibrahim alayhi salam saying, "Oh Allah, these idols, or those idols, have led many people astray. Whoever followed me, oh Allah Ta'ala, you are he is of me. وَمَنْ عَصَانِي, and whoever disobeyed me, you are, O Allah, the oft forgiven, the most merciful." Meaning, Ibrahim is here interceding for his people, for his nation, asking Allah Ta'ala to forgive them, even if they disobeyed him. Subhanallah. وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah forgive them. And likewise, the Nabi Sallam said the verse in which Isa alayhi salam said, "In tu'adhibuhum fa innahum 'ibaduk Isa alayhi salam will say this statement on the Day of Judgment. After he clarifies, peace be upon him, the message that Allah Ta'ala sent him with, he will say, "Oh Allah Ta'ala, I did not ask them to worship me. Oh Allah, I only delivered your message to them. And you were, oh Allah Ta'ala, the witness upon that." And he will say at the end, "In tu'adhibuhum fa'innahum ibaduk." Oh Allah, if you punish them, they are your servants. وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. But oh Allah, forgive them, you are the Almighty, the All-Wise. At that point, the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam wept. Wept out of fear for us. At that time, the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam cried for us. Allah Ta'ala sent Jibreel Islam to ask him, "Oh Muhammad, what made you weep?" He said, "My nation, my nation, my nation, my nation." He wept out of fear for you, for us, for his nation. And Allah Ta'ala said to him, "Oh Muhammad, indeed, we shall please you in regard of your nation." This great Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, every prophet Allah Ta'ala granted him and accepted invocation and accepted da'wah and accepted du'a and accepted supplication, and every prophet made his du'a in his life. Sulaiman Alayhi Salam asked Allah Ta'ala to give him a kingship that nobody was given like it. Allah Ta'ala gave him that kingship. قال رب اغفر لي وهب لي ملكا لا ينبغي لأحد من بعدي. Oh Allah, forgive me and give me a kingship that nobody will give in a like it after me. And Allah Ta'ala gave him that kingship. And every single prophet made his dua in this life. But the Nabi Sallam delayed his dua to the hereafter. Why? As an intercession for his nation, for us, for all of us. He said, لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ دَعْوَةٌ مُسْتَجَابَةٌ. Every prophet has an accepted dua, and I delayed my dua as an intercession for my nation. وَإِنِّي أَخَرْتُهَا شَفَاعَةً لِأُمَّتِي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah, subhanallah, subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah the Almighty send the prayers and the peace and salutation upon you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi. Dear brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you and reward you. How can we, in return, show the love to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How can we follow his guidance? First of all, let's reflect the best of teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our manners. Let's reflect the best of manners in our dealing with people, with Muslims and non-Muslims. Let's show them how the Nabi Sallam used to deal with the people, how he Sallam used to treat people, and how he used to interact with people in a very gentle, kind, and beautiful manner. Some of the Jewish came and said, "Assalamu alaykum, Muhammad." And they used to twist the word, "Assalamu alaykum." Say, "Assalamu alaykum." "Assalamu alaykum" means peace be upon you. "Assalamu alaykum" means death be upon you. They used to twist the word and say, "Assalamu alaykum," very fast. So Rasulullah knew that they are praying against him. What did he say? He said, "Wa alaykum," and upon you as well. Nothing more. And he said to Aisha radiallahu anhu, when he got angry and he said, "May the wrath and the anger of Allah Ta'ala be upon you." He said to her, "O Aisha, behold, O Aisha, ما كان الرفق في شيء إلا زانة." Whenever gentleness is in something, it will beautify it. And whenever gentleness is removed from something, it will turn it ugly. Subhanallah, he was a great example for us, even in dealing with disbelievers. Allahu Akbar. So reflect the best of teachings, the best of manners in your dealing with people, especially with the non-Muslims, if you are living in the non-Muslim countries. Moreover, make sure that you adhere to the five prayers and you offer them as much as you can, so that Nabi Sallam will be able to know you and distinguish you amongst all the people. Adhere to the excellence of manners. Remember that Nabi Sallam will call you on the Day of Judgment and will say, "Come and sit next to me إن من أدناكم وأحبكم إلي مجلسا يوم القيامة أحاسنكم أخلاقا. The dearest to me, the most beloved to me amongst you, and those who will sit next to me on the day of judgment are those who have good manners. Let's take him as a great example, and let's adhere to his character, adhere to his virtues, and adhere to his manners. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. You have indeed in the Nabi sallam a great example. وإن تطيعوه تهتدوا. And if you obey him, you take him as an example, you will be rightly guided. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the love of Muhammad sallam. I ask Allah ta'ala to grant us to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and make him a great model for us and a role model for us in everything, in our actions, in our statements, in our dealing, in our interactions, in all of our affairs. Wassalatu wassalamu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.